guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a video on being afraid of blood. This was a big issue for me when I started my nursing program once I got my acceptance letter. So I went to my dean and I requested a tour of a hospital. My only interactions at a hospital consisted of my brother being born and then me breaking my arm in the emergency room. So I really had no point of reference when it came to working at a hospital. When I took my tour, I requested to follow the venipuncture department, and I also wanted to see the different level of nursing, meaning that I wanted to see a med-surg nurse, med-tele, PCU, ICU, and then hopefully a very critical patient. My nursing program approved that, and then I took a two-hour tour. The venipuncture area was very interesting because it really helped me understand why labs are important. Medical diagnoses are made based on labs. To monitor PTINR daily, you need blood. A lot of people who come in for blood transfusions need daily HNHs or sometimes Q3 HNHs. So venipuncture and blood draws need to be done consistently over and over again. If you're testing for cancer, you need blood draws. Blood, labs, all that in betweenness, all that stuff is needed in the hospital setting and for the medical field in general. And I really loved seeing that. After that presentation, I kind of realized that blood isn't as icky as I thought it was. It's kind of a necessary evil in the healthcare profession. After that little tour, I went to a med-surg floor and a med-tele floor. It's really interesting seeing a nurse take care of 7 patients, and then a nurse on the opposite side, let's say an ICU floor, taking care of 2 patients. I remember my husband was in the CBICU post his cap surgery, and he had a nurse who only had 1 other patient. He was intubated, he had all these tubes coming out of him. It was very scary for me, but my nurse was very comforting. And on each level, whether it was med surg or ICU, I really felt that each nurse was comforting each individual, i.e. the patient and their family members, in them getting discharged and their nursing care in general. After that, I got to see some general surgery areas and then I left. I know you're still thinking, how did this revolve around blood? Well, when I did my very first clinical of my nursing program, 2 of my classmates passed out. And we hadn't even started doing our head-to-toe assessments yet. They passed out because of the smells and the sights overwhelmed their body systems, and their body decided that it needed to reset itself. The smells and the sights of a hospital are very scary if you're not used to them. Changing a baby's diaper, for example, is very normal to some mothers. But when you're changing an adult's diaper who's intubated and drooling and in restraints and fighting you, and their feces has moved to the back of their stage 4 pressure ulcer that you now have to change, and that dressing change takes you 45 minutes, if this is your first or second clinical of your entire nursing program, your mind, your body is rocked. It's just too much, too fast. But I deal with that usually every day at work, and then 30 minutes later, I'm starving. I can go eat a burrito, go down and get a salad or fruit salad. I'm pretty numb to the smells and the sights of the hospital. But initially, when you're a nursing student, your body's not used to that yet. So I'll say the first 3 to 5 months of your nursing program is going to be your body just becoming familiar with the smells and the sights of a hospital. Everyone knows when they smell poop, right? It smells gross. But when you smell C. diff poop, you definitely know the smell and you know what it is. If you don't know what I'm talking about, when you smell it, you'll know what I mean. But in the end, it just comes down to being familiar with your atmosphere. If you're afraid of blood, try to do a tour of a venipuncture or blood draw area at your local hospital. If you're scared of a long-term care facility or a psych area, try to visit these areas. If you can't get a tour, just try going to a hospital and walking around the general accessible areas, meaning that at 2 o'clock in the morning, you shouldn't be trying to steal narcotics, so to speak, but walking around the general lobby areas or down the hallways, it shouldn't be a problem. In the end, everyone's afraid of blood. Everyone is afraid of patients at some point, but you become numb to that, or it becomes familiar to you after a couple months. Everyone is afraid at some point, but you will get over that hump and you will be just fine. If you guys have any questions or comments for me, as always, please put them on the bottom. But please understand that every nurse has been where you are, and you will become the best nurse that you can, and you will overcome this and look back in the past and laugh on it just like me. Once again, thank you for taking the time to watch my video as always, and your support, and have a good day, guys.